डियर स्टूडेंट्स,
टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द स्टेप्स इन लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ ए टिपिकल एंजियोस्पर्मिक प्लांट्स। इट कंप्राइजेस मेनली फोर स्टेप्स, फोर मेजर हेडिंग्स। वन इज डेवलपमेंट दैट लीड्स टू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ मेल गैमेट्स और स्पर्म। बी, डेवलपमेंट दैट लीड्स टू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फीमेल गैमेट एम्ब्रियो सैक। सी, फर्टिलाइजेशन। एंड डी, डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एम्ब्रियो एंड सीड फॉर्मेशन। फर्स्ट हेडिंग अगेन, development that leads to formation of male gametes or sperm, again divided into three main headings: development of anther microsporangium, formation of microspore pollen grains or microsporogenesis, and third one is development of microspore to form mature male gametophyte and formation of sperm. B part comprises development of ovule, that means megasporangium, formation of megaspore, that means megasporogenesis. Third one is development in megaspore, that means and formation of female gametophyte, that means embryo sac and female gamete. Third one is fertilization, major step hai ye. This one is major step, and development of embryo and seed formation. Development that leads to formation of male gamete sperm includes, first, development of anther or microsporangium. We know that micro word is here comes for pollen grains, and angium means thyla or bag. That means pollen grains are found in that bag, that means anther. Clear the concept. These terms are very interesting and very confusing. So, clear the concept of the terminology. Angium, micro. Angium means bag or stack like structure. Micro word is used for pollen grains. That means micro means pollen grains are found in that angium, that means thyla, that means that place where pollen grains are found is known as anther. That means microsporangium is regarded as anther in case of angiospermic plants. In this case, development of microsporangium is of eusporangiate type. What is the meaning of this eusporangiate? That means group of initial cells, not a single cell. That means group of cells are involved here, and involved in the formation of microsporangium. So this is which type of eusporangiate type of development occur. In this case, few cells of hypodermal region becomes differentiated to form archisporial cells. In case of Borrhaevia, these are the exceptional case. Borrhaevia and Dionaea, in this case only one archisporial cells are found. Archisporial cells divides periclinally, that means along the periphery, to form two layers, outer parietal layer and inner sporogenous layer. Outer primary parietal layer and inner sporogenous layer.
primary parietal layer
is again primary parietal layer below the which lies below the epidermis again divide pericleanly and to form 3 to 5 layers concentric rings or concentric layers, and these layers form wall of sporangium, and the innermost layer of the wall called as tapetum, and this tapetum provide nutrition to developing pollen grains. This is the one of the important point which is regularly asked in the competitive exams. What is the function of tapetum? The function of tapetum is provide nutrition to the developing pollen grains. Who provide the nutrition to developing pollen grains? Tapetum provide the nutrition to the developing pollen grains. The layer just below the epidermis is called endothecium. In some books, endothecium. Now, sporogenous layer may function directly as pollen mother cell. Sporogenous layer may function directly as pollen mother cell, or it divide to form many pollen mother cells. That means sporogenous cells form pollen mother cells. Sporogenous tissue form pollen mother cells. Anther wall consists of following 4 layers from outer to inner side. Following 4 layers are found: epidermis single layered, endothecium single layered, middle layer 2 to 3 layered, and tapetum single layered and innermost layer, which provide nutrition to developing pollen grains. Endothecium consists of radially elongated cells and are hygroscopic in nature. That means moisture absorbing cells. They absorb the moisture and burst. These help in dehiscence of the anther, splitting of the anther to release the spore. This is the figure of microsporangium anther and the TS of anther, which showing the cellular structure of microsporangium. This is section of anther, which is it is the enlarged size of the anther. This is the cellular structure of the microsporangium. The outermost layer is epidermis. This is the epidermis layer. Second one is endothecium. This is the middle layer. This is the tapetum layer, that means nutritive layer, and these are the PMC, pollen mother cell. What is PMC? Microspore mother cell. एमसी माइक्रो स्पोर मदर सेल, MOTHER मदर सेल, दिस इज नाउ टेपिटम. टेपिटम इज द इनर मोस्ट लेयर विच प्रोवाइड न्यूट्रिशन टू द डेवलपिंग पॉलन ग्रेन्स. वी नो दैट वेरी वेल. दीज टेपिटम आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स ऑन देयर बिहेवियर. दे आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स. वन इज ग्लैंडुलर एंड अदर इज अमीबॉइड. ग्लैंडुलर आर सिक्रेटरी आर पेराइटल टेपिटम. दीज आर दे आर रिमेन्स एज सच इन देयर ओरिजिनल पोजिशन. रिमेन एज सच इन देयर ओरिजिनल पोजिशन थ्रू आउट द माइक्रोस्पोर डेवलपमेंट. They secrete nutritive substance for the development of the spores. But amoeboid tapetum, the cells, the radial wall and inner walls become breaks, and cytoplasm release in the chamber in the cavity and make a mass of periplasmodium, and this periplasmodium perform amoeboid movement, so called as amoeboid tapetum. They move from one to another place. It provide nourishment to the sporogenous tissue. They are most common in hydrophytes. Thus we have today discussed about the development of anther microsporangium. In the next session we will discuss next topic.